going to talk about two important things. One is the don't care. So even name is don't care, but we'll care about this. And second is the function realization from truth table. Means if you have a truth table available with you and you have made a truth table, then how to make a function from that truth table. And we'll see one exercise as well where you make the truth table. Well, we'll give one question and you will prepare the truth table as well, right? So these all things we'll do in today's lecture. So let's first talk about don't care. So there are many scenarios when particular type of input is never available, or a set of input will never available. Now you can say, how it is possible? So for example, you have taken age as into the consideration. Now in case of age, is it is possible like you will get negative age, like age is minus 20 years, age is minus 30 years, age is minus 40 years. That is not possible, at least in the real scenario, right? So in that case, suppose if we take example of your Python or Java, let's say Java, so you are taking integer for that. So instead of taking integer, which is signed integer, we can take unsigned integer as well, because you already know we do not have negative values. So once you take unsigned integer, then automatically your range will be doubled in positive side, not right. So in that case, if you are aware about the inputs, that particular type of input will not available, then you can take a particular action over there. That will helpful for you can say to make more efficient program. Now similar thing happen in the digital system as well. If you know that particular set of input will never occur in the system, will never come into the system, then those kind of input sets will treat as a don't care set, or you can say the respective output will go as a don't care output. Why we are saying don't care? Because we already know that these particular set of input will never come into the picture, will never occur into the system. Now so the same thing here, like input values for min terms which will never occur, that will known as a don't cares, right? Now how we'll represent those don't cares, we'll represent by x. Once we'll see a few examples, then you'll understand much better. Now let's look into this example. We already know BCD codes, right? Now if you say BCD codes, we have 4-bit in hand. In case of BCD code, we have 4-bit in hand, right? So in that case, suppose you said I want to represent bits in the form of A, B, C, D, let's say, right? So means you have 4-bit. So suppose if you want to represent, let's say here we have number, if you want to represent 1, so you'll say, sorry, if you want to represent 0, so it will be 0, 0, 0, 0. So means bit A will become 0, B will become 0, C will become 0, D will become 0. Similarly, if you want to represent 9, you'll say 1, 0, 0, 1. Now I want to use this entire coding to represent my system. Getting? Now what beautiful thing here, guys, please mute your mic if you don't want to speak. If you want to speak something, then it's fine. Okay. Now if we have 4-bit values, then 1010, this is also possible as input. If you say how many possible inputs with this 4-bit combination, then you have 16 possible inputs. Out of 16, we are using only 10, 0 to 9. But if you say value 10, that is 1010, we never use in the BCD system. Similarly, you say 1011, that will also we are not using into the BCD system, right? Similarly, you can say 1100, that will also not use into the BCD system. Because if you want to represent, let's say 11, so in that case, you will not utilize this. What you will do, you will make 0001, 0001. So ultimately, if you look into the BCD system, is there any chance these set of inputs these set of inputs will come into the this particular BCD system. Is there any chance? What do you think? Is they will come into the system or not? Anyone? At least say yes, no. I don't know.
Don't know, sir.
Right. So in that case, let's take example here. Same example. Suppose I am saying I have A, B, C, D. These are the four bits that we have used in the combination of 8421 coding. This is also known as BCD coding, if you remember. Now, suppose you want to represent 99 in the BCD. So how you will write 1001, 1001. This is representing 99. Suppose you want to represent 85, then what you will do, you will say 1000, 0101. Now suppose you want to represent 11. In that case, you'll say 0001, 0001. Right? Now, if I want to write all the combination that you can make with 4-bit, because ultimately you are using 4-bit here, right? So if you make all the combination, you will say 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 0001 this? How this combination can, comes into the picture? Any doubt how we have written this combination? Anyone?
No, sir. No, sir.
Right. So we have these 16 combinations. Now, if we say this BCD system, out of these 16 combinations, how many combinations will come into the picture? Those will be used to represent the entire BCD till this 0 to 9. Now, because with 4 bit, you can represent 16 combinations. But only these 10 combinations have been used. In that case, what will happen to remaining these 6 combinations? Is these 6 combinations will come into the picture while we are representing in BCD? Any case? Can you give any way so that we can utilize these combinations in BCD system, where BCD is represented like this? Is there any chance so that we can utilize these input combination?
So if we are representing signed numbers,
then also they will not come into the picture. Then you will represent extra bit, but ultimately BCD will represent in the same way. If you say number, then they will come into the same way. I am talking about BCD representation, that is 8421 coding. So suppose you are saying I have a number 100. In that case, you will say 0001, 0000, 0000. Suppose I want to represent 12. So then what you will do in BCD, 0001, 0010. You will not use this 12. This combination will not be used. What will be used? This combination will be used. So in short, you can say these set of combination will never occur in the system. Got my point? What I want to tell. Got it or not?
Yes, sir.
Anyone, any doubt on this? Why these are not coming into the picture? Anyone? The reason behind why they will never occur in the system?
Sir, सारे two digit, one digit से तो बनते हैं sir. तो one digit use वही रहे हैं.
Right. One digit तो हम ले ही रहे हैं. So two digit की हमें need नहीं है. Right. क्योंकि what we are doing here, हम we are taking this BCD representation, not binary representation. We are taking BCD coding for that. Once you say BCD coding, we already have one bit representation, one number representation, and we make the combination of that. So in that case, we already know, we have prior information that these set of inputs will never occur in the system. So the respective output for this system will become don't care. And these real represented by X. While we'll try to optimize. Any doubt why these are don't care, first of all? Then we'll see how to utilize this don't care. Any doubt on this?
No, sir.
Cool. So while we design the system, if we are sure like particular set of inputs will never occur in the system, then we can utilize them as don't care. Now you can say how to utilize them. So let's look into one example. Suppose we have this system, this function is given to me, and here these are the minterms. It means these are the places where we have ones, and we are saying we have three don't cares. Don't cares means 1, 4, 6 will never come into the picture, means that these particular set of inputs will never occur into the system. So you can say these are the don't cares. So let's understand how to utilize this don't care. So first I'm using only this, and then in the second step we'll utilize this don't care. So let me draw. So can you make a function for this? So try at your end as well. Try to make a function for this using kmap. So please try to solve at your end as well. So just draw a kmap, feed these values. It is A, B, C, D, A bar, B bar. Now I want to fill these values just only once. I'm right now, I'm not worried about don't care. So 0, 1, 2, 3. We have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Cool. Right. So we have this system. Now what, how you will make pair and quad here? Can anyone solve it? Anyone try to solve it? So we have one quad available here, one quad available here. If we have quad, then we will not make pair, because if you make pair, you have one extra literal. If you make quad, you have lesser literal. For this, definitely I will make a pair. So if you are able to make quad, go for quad. Don't go for the pair. Right. So let me give the numbering so that we can find out. So this is your first, this is your second, and this one is your third, so that we can write function. So what will be the function for first? AB.
AB plus AD.
Plus AD plus. This one, B bars, CD.
B bars, CD.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Right. So we got this expression. Now I'm saying I want to utilize these don't cares. So let me draw another K map so that we can clearly get the difference. So let me fill everything quickly here. CD. So let me first fill all ones. So we have one here. One. Now I want to fill this don't care and they will fill by X. So they are saying position one. I'm saying position one. Then position four, 0, 1, 2, 3 in position 4, 5, 6. They said like this. Right. Now, how to utilize them? So first of all, these positions, these X will be utilized to make bigger combination if it is possible, right? So how we can do it? Let me do it for you quickly. Let me do it. So here we have
a sir, word. Sir, X hai wo one or one ke beech mein nahi aayega.
Kaun sa?
सेकेंड लाइन में फोर सिक्स है वो थर्ड पोजीशन पे आएगा ना
फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन
ओके
फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन
तब फर्स्ट पोजीशन वाला कह रहा है वो
ये है ना फोर
वन भी तो है वन पे भी तो है
ये लिख दिया ना वन जीरो वन
अच्छा 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 अच्छा
वन पे एक्स बना है ना गेटिंग सो नाउ प्रीवियसली व्हाट वी वाज एबल टू डू वी वाज एबल टू मेक दिस पेयर ओनली बट एज डोंट केयर इज अवेलेबल सो व्हाट वी कैन डू वी कैन यूटिलाइज इट एंड मेक ए क्वाड फॉर दिस राइट नाउ डू वी रियली नीड दिस डोंट केयर्स नो We do not need because if you utilize them, then there is not they are not going to optimize because no ones are available. So important point: they are supporting element. They are not compulsory element that we need to you can say take care. They are just supporting element. If they help us to make better combination, like you can increase the size of pair, like either instead of pair you can make quad or instead of quad you can make octet. Then only we'll utilize them. If they are remain all alone, means there is no ones left right now. So then these combination or these X will not be useful for us. Only this X is useful for us. Getting? So it is not compulsory that you need to cover these X. No, these are just supporting element. If they are supporters to optimize the function, then only we'll utilize. Otherwise we left them. Getting so now let us write the function so here one x is helpful for us because previously we have made a pair but now with the help of this x we can make a quad here so if now let's write the function so for simplicity let me write this a bar b a p bar C bar, D bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. So what will be the function? Can anyone tell? So definitely AB will be there from previous. Then this quad is also there. One more important point. One more important point. Look into the second combination. This quad, what we have made. Okay, just give me a minute.
AD.
Just give me a minute. Look into this. Look into this quad, that square one. This one. Is this quad is possible?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Right. So we do not need this. Actually, we do not need this because all ones are already covered. So this quad doesn't have a single one which is not covered by other. In that case, this quad is not required, right? So if we do not require this quad, then why unnecessary will keep it? So let us remove this quad. Yeah. Getting. So now you have a function AB plus
B bar D.
B bar D. Now you can compare. Once you use this, we have not used this don't care, then our function was AB plus AD plus B bar CD. Now once you use only one single X, that we already aware that will never occur in the system, so we can utilize it. So then we make a quad and we have this function. So which one is more optimal? Let's do the second one. Getting? Got the point how this don't care is useful for optimization of the function. Right? Any doubt, guys? Anyone?
No, sir.
Anyone, any doubt?
No, sir.
Right. Okay. One more thing that I want to tell you. Suppose bytes, let me take different color. Suppose color combination would come. Suppose by chance we have made a combination. Dikhega. Sir, black. Okay. Suppose we have by chance, by mistake, you have made this. You have made this. You have made this. And definitely this one. Where again we have three chords. So then this is not also optimized fun. Because as we have seen, we can make it with two chords only. We can solve it with two chords only. So that you have to keep in mind, whatever minimum function is there, that so there is no compulsion to cover these X. So we are not worried about this one. Getting? So.
सर क्यों नहीं बना सकते सर इसमें मतलब ये वाला क्वार्ट
बिकॉज़ नहीं वी आर नॉट लाइक वी विल हैव देन थ्री क्वार्ट्स एंड वंस वी हैव थ्री क्वार्ट यू विल हैव सिक्स लिटरल्स
पर उसके हिसाब से मतलब जो आपने बताया था उसमें तो 16 8 4 2 फिर 1 तो सर उस हिसाब से तो सर बढ़िया है ना सर अपने लिए अगर अपन फोर क्वार्ट मिला देते
अगर हमारे पास दो क्वार्ड से काम हो रहा है तो हम तीसरा क्वार्ड क्यों लेके आएंगे दैट्स द रीजन इन दिस करंट केस वी रिक्वायर्ड ओनली टू क्वार्ड सो व्हाई वी अननेसेसरी इंट्रोड्यूस थर्ड क्वार्ड हियर गेटिंग गॉट इट और नॉट
यस सर यस सर
अगर हमारा काम दो रुपए में बन रहा है सो वाई वील इंट्रोड्यूस थर्ड रुपी क्यों हम इन्वेस्ट करेंगे तीसरा जब हमारा काम तो दो में ही हो रहा है राइट सो दैट्स द रीजन गेटिंग एनी डाउट गाइस एनीवन एनी डाउट इन दिस एग्जांपल
सर वो एक बार वो है एडी वाला जो क्वार्ट था वो वाला बता दो वो क्यों नहीं बनाया मतलब जो एडी वाला जो था
राइट सो ओके सो लेट मी फर्स्ट मेक इट देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड So you are saying why we have not made this quad, right?
Yes, sir.
So just check out this quad. Is there any one is available which is not covered by other?
No, sir.
In that case, the condition is false. Getting?
Okay, sir.
At least one should be there that is not covered by other.
Okay, sir.
Got it? Let me erase. Okay. So just try to solve this at your end. Try to solve this. I will also solve, but you will solve at your end as well. So we have given a function along with the don't care एंड we will try to solve this with the don't care and find out the final output. So we are saying a bar b bar a bar b कोई कर रहा है सॉल्व?
यस सर.
ओके ओके ग्रेट. ओके नाउ लेट अस फिल द इंफॉर्मेशन. So 2, 4, 10, 12, 14. And what are the don't cares? It's 0, 1, 5, and 8. So how many quads, how many pairs?
Sir,
two quads, one pair.
I think all quads is there. No pair required. So
only two quads.
Only two quads.
So two quads and one pair, I think.
Three quads.
I think three quads required. Exactly. All corners are also there, na? So you can utilize them to make the chord. So let me make it so that you also. So first of all, let me take all the corners. Right. Then you can say I have this. And then you can say I have this. What it? Any doubt on this? Anyone?
How we sir, have made not, this? Sir, why not 0, 1, 4, 5? That one is also a quad.
But why it is required? We are not worried about X. We are worried about 1. Even if you make 0, 1, 4, 5, that is also fine. That is also fine, no problem on that. So instead of, as you said, instead of this, you can make this as well.
So we can take either of them, not both.
Yes, both is not possible because then suppose now you make this one, that long rectangular form. Then no single one is available that is not covered by it.
Sir?
Sorry, yes. Sir, I didn't understand.
Okay. Just give me a minute. By chance, suppose you have made this quad. Now check this quad. Is there any single one which is not covered by other? This is also covered. This is also covered. So this one is covered by this and this one is covered by this. So you do not have any single one which is not covered by other. In that case, this quad is not possible. Getting? So you have choice. Either you make this or you make this.
Yes, sir. Yes, I got it.
Got it.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, the conditions which you apply on the ones is also applicable on X. It must be an independent or no. Not coming in.
X is always supporting.
So it may be coming twice or thrice. That is not.
No problem. That can come anytime. So here our target to cover all ones. If X are supporting to make bigger set, then they will be utilized. But there is no compulsion to cover those X. X is always supporting element. Getting? They are not compulsory element that we need to take care. Got it? One we need to take care because that is part of the function. Those which are part of the function, they must need to take care. But those which are don't care, they are help us to further optimize. They are not part of the function. They are help us to further optimize the function to make a bigger set. Getting? Any doubt, guys, till now?
No, sir.
Cool. So now what will be the function in that case?
A bar C bar.
A bar C bar कहाँ से आया यार? मुझे तो दिख ही नहीं रहा है A bar C bar. Okay, you are using this one.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then I have to modify it. Just a minute. Otherwise, these two combination. Not work out. So in that case, this combination we have made, right? So A bar C bar from this square. What about this? A D bar.
A D bar.
And what about in all corners? B bar
D bar. D bar.
Right. Now suppose we have another don't care. And that is in the place of 6. By chance, if you have this don't care, so means we will put this here. Now what you will do?
Sir, one C bar D bar is also there.
Sorry?
Two quads.
Why two quads? Why not octet?
Octet.
Single octet is good enough. Right, single octet is good enough because you will take this entire and done. Ready? Okay, cool. So you got the idea. What is the story here? Now let us move forward and let's look into the second important point, that is the function realization. Any doubt on don't care? How to use them? Mm-hmm. How to find them? That, yes. Clear,
I hope. Clear, sir.
Cool. Great. Now let's talk about function realization. So suppose for a particular, for particular operation, for particular task, you have made your truth table. Means you have made your design in the form of truth table. Okay, if this input will be there, that final output will be this one, right? So you have made this table. Now I want to make function for this. Right. I just want to make function for this. In that case, you can simply say we can use kmap to make the function for this. So how to use the kmap? Let me draw kmap for you quickly. And we'll fill the information. Right. So for quick reference, let me give the numbering. 0 1 2 3 4 6 7 x bar x y bar z bar y bar z y z bar. Can we fill these numbers here? So you have to fill all the places where one are there. So 1 2 3 4 and 7. Okay. So now, can we make any pair here? Any quad? Any possibility? Do we have any possibility to make a pair or quad?
No, sir.
So if we do not have any possibility, then we have to go with the singletons. Right. So then you will make a function that is, so let's look into first this, then this, one by one we can go for it. X, y bar, z bar plus x bar, y bar, z plus this one x, y, z, then plus x bar, y, z bar, x bar, y, z bar.
तो x बार होगा वहाँ पे सर लास्ट में आपका मैंने भूल गया
राइट थैंक यू सो नाउ वी गॉट दिस फंक्शन फ्रॉम हियर नाउ लेट्स लुक इनटू दिस टेबल इज एनी देयर एनी स्पेशल थिंग इन टेबल जस्ट लुक इनटू दिस टेबल एंड फाइंड आउट सम स्पेशल थिंग इज गोइंग ऑन समथिंग स्पेशल सम स्पेशल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ दिस टेबल ओके जस्ट काउंट नंबर ऑफ वंस
सर मतलब ऊपर वाले जो फर्स्ट रो है तो उसमें सारे जीरोज हैं तो लास्ट वाली रोज में सारे वन है और अगर सेकंड लास्ट रो की बात करें तो उसमें टू वन है तो ऊपर वाली में टू जीरोज है फिर एक सिंगल
वो तो ठीक है आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस साइड आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस एंटायर टेबल लाइक आउटपुट एनी स्पेशल थिंग इन द आउटपुट वो तो दैट इज द ऑब्वियस वे लाइक वंस यू हैव 3 बिट नंबर यस
सर एक नंबर दूसरे कॉम्प्लीमेंट आ रहा है
कॉम्प्लीमेंट है सर एक दूसरे का अगर जीरो से सेवन में देखे तो
सर अगर दो वन आ रहे हैं तो सर मतलब नंबर ऑफ अगर वंस ऑड है तो फिर वो जीरो दे रहा है
यस 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 एग्जैक्टली दिस इज द एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट आंसर दैट इज द स्पेशल थिंग हियर इफ यू हैव नंबर ऑफ वंस odd then the output is one if your number of ones are even then output is zero just cross check just count here number of ones in the input and check the output can you get it look at like last number of ones are odd output is one number of ones are even output is zero and so on and this particular special variety of function is known as even parity check it is even parity and this is heavily used in the security system whenever you send some data from one place to another place in order to check the integrity of data correctness of data this even parity check is used similarly odd parity check is also used somewhere now let's look into this function this particular function and let's try to optimize this or look into some different ways so I am taking this and this together like x term together and x bar together so once we say x bar what we'll get y bar z plus y z bar plus x y bar z bar plus y z now if I am want to give this a different value let's say I want to give this as a t what is this if it is t if this is t then is this is t bar can we say this is t bar
this is x bar, this is x OR gate, this is x NOR gate
okay so let me do it for you quickly so I have y bar z plus y z bar and if I am taking the complement of this so you will get y plus z dot y plus z bar dot y bar plus z getting now let's multiply them together or is it taking so you will get y y bar will rid of plus y z plus y bar z bar plus z z bar this will gone we'll have only this check out is this both are same
yes sir
means you can say if it is T, this is T bar. And if you check out, this is your XOR gate and this is your XNOR gate. If you remember, and they are complement to each other, right? So let me use this T and say X bar T plus X T bar. What is this function? It is XOR. If you look into this function, this is XOR. Right, so you can say X XOR T. Now I'm looking for T. What is T? Y XOR Z. So if you look into this function, it is Y XOR Z. Okay, so let me write T here for you. Y bar Z plus Y Z bar. What is this? Y XOR Z. So in short, you can say it is X XOR Y XOR Z. This is your function. And this function is used for event parity check. Got it? Any doubt on this, anyone? Any particular place? Guys, any doubt?
No, sir. Clear. No, sir.
Cool.
No, sir.
Good, good. Now, seven segment display ki photo bound. Okay, let me draw the seven segment display. Okay. So if you remember your calculator, that calculator has seven segments. Have you checked it out anytime? Is something like this. थोड़ा सा और close बनाना चाहिए था.
सर आ गया.
समझ में आ जाना चाहिए. A B C D E F and G. So these are the seven segments. A B C D E F G, right? And based on that, you are representing a number. So you can say these A B C D E F G. These are the LEDs that will glow. So once you will represent a number, respective LED will glow, right? So now let me write. So I'm saying LED will go means output will come into the picture. So I will say A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now I want to represent. So let me say watch number. I want to represent zero. So in that case, which LEDs will glow, which will not glow? If these are all LEDs.
No one will glow, sir.
क्या बात कर रहे हो? जीरो दिखेगा कैसे?
तो सर वी कैन जीरो 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 तो सर सारे जीरो जाएंगे ना?
So then nothing will display. Nothing will display. So suppose you want to display zero into the you can say your calculator, then respective LED should be glowing. So in that case, your G will not glow. Rest all will glowing, then only you can see the zero into the picture, or you can say into the calculator. Just think on calculator, those lines in the calculator are LEDs. Which line are glowing based on like which number you want to represent based on those LEDs are glowing. Suppose you want to represent one. In that case, your B and C will glow, rest nothing will glow. So this and this will glow. Rest nothing will glow. Then only you can see the one. Suppose you are seeing two. So how you'll represent two? Yes. So this is glowing.
Yes, sir. F A B G G E C.
G E D.
D. Why, sir? D.
okay, let me I think I had made some wrong picture, that's why this confusion is coming. Should make more proper picture. This will not be. This will see the actual. Sorry. Okay, now I'm giving the number A, this is E, this is C, this is T, E, F, and G. Now, in case of two, what will glow, what will not glow? Let's forget about this. Yes, anyone?
F, A, B,
A, B, G, E, D.
A, B, G, E, D.
Yes, sir.
Right. So A, B, G, E, and D will glow. These two will not glow. Similarly, you can go up to 9. Suppose I want to represent 9. So actually 9 is representing like this in our calculator. Right. So F, E, and D will off. Remain all will be okay. If you want to represent 9, so F will be off.
F will also glow, sir. F will glow.
F will glow.
E
yes,
will
definitely.
Only.
Sir, only E will not glow, sir.
Nein. Only E will not glow. E and D.
Yes, sir. No, sir. No, D
will glow. Calculator pe depend karta hai na, wo to E aur D wala to.
Yes, true. So suppose someone is written like this, then D will glow. If someone is written like this, then D will not glow. So just check out how it is representing. Based on that, you can decide D will glow or not, right? So in that way, you are able to make the entire truth table here for 7 segment display, right? So let me, what is the time? Okay, we already over. So we can simply say, suppose I am going with this, let's say. So we are seeing this one, C will be also 1. D will be 0, E will be 0, F will be 1, and G will be 1. So in that way, you can represent all the numbers, right? Now, you can say what will be the input? Let me say X, W, X, Y, Z as an input for this. So we are saying the input for this is W, X, Y, and Z. Now, these are the binary values, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, and so on. You'll get 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So these are the inputs and these are the outputs, right? Now what you will do in order to make this function, so you have, let me say, you have a black box function where we have 4 inputs, W, X, Y, and Z, and we have 7 outputs. Right, 7 outputs A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Right, in this 7 output, you have function. So, what you will do first, you will pick first output, you will make a K map for this. Right, so this is the K map for A, and you will get a function A equal to function of W, X, Y, and Z. Right. Then similarly, we'll do for B, F of W, X, Y, and Z. In that way, you'll get all the functions, and then that combination of function will club together. And that will become your final function. Now, one more last point, just give me 1 minute only. One last point. While you are realizing this function, you can find out after 9, this will, remaining input will never occur in the system. So we can say remaining input 001001. So it should be 1010, 1011, and so on 1111. they are become don't care for you. So we can utilize this don't care while you are making function of a, b, c, d, e, f, g. Getting? So in that way, you can make a 7-segment display. Got it, everyone? I hope you got some idea. Guys, any doubt? Anyone?
No.
Cool. So rest remain. So we'll do few more, little bit more practice. How once we have multiple functions as in the output, how we'll utilize the K-map and make entire functionality available for us. Okay, guys. Okay, so that's it for today. I'm already overshooting the time.